It's time for the match game, Hollywood Squares Hour, with the stars of NBC daytime dramas from another world, Christopher Rich, Nancy Frangione. From Search for Tomorrow, David Forsyth. Marcia McCabe. From Days of Our Lives, Leann Hunley. And the stars of the match game, Hollywood Squares Hour, Gene Rayburn and John Bowman.
Thank you. Not bad.
Thank you. Thank you very much. It appears that your fans are out here in force.
Isn't that nice?
We have all of you people out here in the studio today who watch daytime drama on NBC, and that's what it's going to be all week here. Represented by Another World, mm-hmm. Days of Our Lives, and Search for Tomorrow. Now, how many of you had to come in from New York? Some of you did, didn't you?
I did.
Oh, yes.
There's only one
she
who
did.
Didn't.
Only one who didn't.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
That's why she looks more rested than yeah.
And your
yes.
flight was late taking off?
Yes, 4 hours.
We even came back into New York again before we left.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Are you okay? Is there something we can get for you?
No, I think I will be fine.
he obviously left his jacket in New York, which is why I had to go back.
Well, he has an extensive wardrobe, which we're going to see as we go on.
Well, Gene, I just want to say that we appreciate having us back. But last time we were here, we were overpowered by the wit, the comedy of the. I mean, we have Fred Travellina, Charles Nelson Reilly. Oh. But this week we don't have to worry about it. David's here. He's not funny, he's not clever.
You make us all look
and
great.
We're gonna look great.
Terrific. David, you're off to a great start here. They really set you up.
This is great.
Okay.
Just that remark will make all the fan magazines.
As long as I've got that here to have a running commentary, I know I'm in good shape.
All right, let's say hello to our two players here. Roy Chowdhury and Arla Knauer. Hello there. And Roy Chowdhury. Tell us about you, Anne. You have a very unusual name, Anne Roy Chowdhury.
I have a very unusual first name, too. It's Anuradha. My American friends call me Anne.
Anuradha?
Yes.
Doesn't mean Anne in English, does
no,
it?
No, they're lazy.
They're what?
Friends are lazy. They wanted to call me Anne.
Oh. Now, where are you from?
I've been born and raised in Calcutta, India, and I came here 4 years ago to go to school. And I'm a very proud and exhausted English major, but I'm proud because I'm going to get my first college degree next month.
Congratulations. That's marvelous. Okay, Anne, good luck here. Arla Knauer, let's find out about you, please.
I'm originally from the state of Washington. I now live in Fountain Valley. I have two children. I do singing telegrams and deliver balloon bouquets for a living, and I love it.
Really?
Singing telegrams, uh-huh.
You do that a lot?
Yes, and I write my own funny lyrics most of the time.
And are you a singer? Is that an avocation?
I started out doing that, and it got tough out there, and so I started my own little company.
Yeah.
And, is she going to be dressed as the Easter Bunny tomorrow?
Is she going to be
dressed? Yes,
yeah,
I am.
Are you really? Right. At the moment we're taping this is the day before Easter, so she's probably going to have a very busy day
busy
tomorrow.
Busy Easter day.
Can well, I ask a question, Gene?
Yes, you may.
Does the company that you work for do those stripograms, too?
Stripograms? You do those, Arla? Yes, she does.
No,
I can tell. I can tell by the way she's blushing she does.
I'll give her the address.
Okay, Arla, you're going to give us a sample of your work right now.
For you, though.
You do?
Yes.
All right, let's hear it.
Gene and John, everyone sure loves you. No one hosts a game show the way you do. Sometimes I have missed my shower to watch you for that hour. I'd even pay to watch each day, so I'm singing this big thank you.
Hey! John?
Good, Arla. And now, the big finish! fish.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, I'll do my imitation of Balazsa.
No, that's not what he had in mind,
no,
but we'll skip that.
Mind.
All right, let's start the match game here. You'll each have three chances to match the loony birds over there, and the one who's done that most often will win and go on to meet the returning champion and challenge in Hollywood Squares for a chance to win up to $30,000. And you won the toss. We'll ask you to go first.
A, please.
Let's see what A says. Sylvia said it was a big mistake letting mean Marcia be the flower girl at my wedding. It's just a euphemistic thing.
It's
we don't even
you.
Spell it. We said M-A-R-S-H-A.
Well,
no one spells it that way. Speed up. We just started. What the heck is that? That's the first question. What do you mean, speed up? Holy mackerel. Anyway, instead of rose petals, she threw blank under my feet.
Can you repeat
all
that
right.
quickly?
Yes.
Sylvia said it was a big mistake letting me and Marcia be the flower girl at my wedding. Instead of rose petals, she threw blank under my feet.
Here we go, Nancy, whether you're ready or not.
Yeah, we're going to go. Hurry up.
And Sylvia said it was a big mistake letting me and Marcia be the flower girl at my wedding. Instead of rose petals, she threw blank under my feet.
Floor wax?
Floor wax to make her slip, okay.
And there was a carpet, too.
Good idea.
It was interesting.
What'd you say, Leanne?
Oh, I have to be first.
Always.
Well.
Show and tell. Say it and hold it up at the same time.
I don't know.
Come
dirt.
On.
Dirt.
They're all
horrible. All right.
Well, it certainly
Leanne.
Doesn't match floor
worry.
Wax.
Well,
you'll get the hang of it later.
Boy, yeah. Now this is the answer, time. Folks. I've got the answer, okay? Instead of rose petals, obviously she threw tacks. She had a
tack.
One.
That's a good one. Yeah.
Absolutely.
Very good one.
Tacky answer, Chris. Tacky answer.
Excuse me. The definitive answer, thorns would
rose
have
made thorn.
Very
hey, that's
windy.
A very good idea. Rose thorns is quite good, very imaginative. All right, Ann, let's see what John has for you.
And she's from India, you know, so I figured nails, you know, like the
nails,
guys.
Some better nails, right. From Calcutta.
That was really stupid.
That was good.
Now, David, Ann would like to know what answer you have because she's very anxious to make a match with you, if you'd like to match with her.
She would like to make a match with
yeah,
me.
Yes, yeah, she would like to make a match with
I'd like
with
to
you.
Make a match with her, too.
Okay, of course.
She was so mean that she threw banana peels.
Banana peels. Make her fall. Yeah.
That's a mean lady.
A good one. Marcia?
This, now, Dave.
Beginner's
Dave,
luck.
Really?
Dave and I are paramours on the show, and this is how in tune we
I
are.
I did not.
I, too, said banana peels.
You did that.
I was cheating.
All right.
You mean...
Now, Arla, let's see what we have for you.
Cheated. It wasn't
ESPN. Here it is. This is Arla's first round question. At the Olympics, Jerry said, last night I went out with Olga the athlete, and what a mistake. I tried to kiss her, and she hit me in the face with a blank. Here we go, Arla.
I blew this one, boy.
At the Olympics, Jerry said, last night I went out with Olga the athlete, and what a mistake. I tried to kiss her, and she hit me in the face with a blank.
With a sweat sock.
With a sweat sock. An old sock. Wow. A lovely idea. That'll put him off. Leanne, what have you got?
I don't think I like being in this first chair. I'm going to be the first one to fall. A weight?
A weight? Like yeah. A... Right. One of those things they use for weight.
Oh,
things.
Come on.
No.
Yeah. Folks, yeah, that's not all that right. bad. That's not that bad.
It's
I went with
booze.
The equipment for him, too. You know, I said a javelin.
A javelin? All right. Hit him in the face with a javelin.
I was going to go with javelin.
Yes.
And I think you were thinking of, were you thinking of a shot put?
Shot put, that's one possibility.
Oh, barbell. I'm
a shot put barbell.
That's not how you spell
John?
It, though, I'm sure.
Sweat sock is a beautiful, imaginative,
right.
evocative answer.
However,
but I said javelin.
All right. Arla, good answer and no match so far. David?
Well, she was a pretty hefty lady, so I thought that she might throw a barbell.
Barbell?
Yeah.
Marcia?
Well, now, Olga the athlete was actually a discus thrower.
A discus thrower.
A
good one.
Discus.
So there's round one. 0-0 the score. Round two coming up right after this for you. Here we go. Round two. Since the score is tied and she went first last time, you go first this time.
B, please.
All right. This is Arla's second round question, and it reads this. Richard Simmons said... He said, it's tough. No, I'm sorry. He said...
I'm telling
he
you.
Said,
now, Gene, be nice.
Okay. He said... Why are you fat? No, he said, it's tough having fat Frida in my exercise class. The only way I can get her to move... is to brock... he says the only way I can get her to move is to drop a blank down her leotard.
I'm gonna be moving, Frida.
Ready, Nancie?
Yeah.
Here we go. Arla.
Lagging today.
Richard Simmons said, it's tough having fat Frida in my exercise class. The only way I can get her to move is to drop a blank down her leotard.
A firecracker.
Firecracker. Another good one, but I don't think it's going to get you anywhere. Firecracker is kind of it's a good answer, but it's a little out in left field. What do you say?
I didn't catch all that stuff you were saying earlier. I wonder if you could run through that one more time.
Oh, yes, of course.
Where do I send that, Jim? I want to play.
I call 914-732-7654-321-5 center.
I said something squishy and wiggly and icky.
Frog is a good one.
Thank you.
Very good, Leann. Oh. See?
Those of us out in left field, Gene.
Yes.
Prefer to think of dynamite, which is very close, right? To a firecracker.
Hey, wait a minute. Hold everything. Let him think about it.
No.
Dynamite.
You know what he says? Always the judge over there, he's saying, see, a firecracker is this big. Dynamite is this big. They don't know what's up. Nancie.
Shoot.
Move up there. I have to move back.
Because we want her to win.
What do you got?
We want both of you to win. But anyway, I have ice cube.
Oh, that's a good one. Ice cube is very good.
That's good. That's good.
That'd get her moving. Bring that ice cube down there and boy, you... Yes.
Actually, I don't know if this would make that much of an impression on Fat Frida. I said a jumping bean.
That's another good one. Jumping bean would be good.
How about a cockroach?
Okay.
Slowly they turn.
All right, David.
Well, great minds think along the same paths, and I also said ice cube.
Ice cube.
Are you equating your mind with mine, David?
I took a slightly different tack on this question, and obviously it was the wrong one, but I said... A chocolate bar dropped down her...
Chocolate bar?
Well, I thought maybe...
Yes, that's what I thought,
too. Wait a minute. Give her a chance to explain. Why would a chocolate bar make you...
No, I was going to do the same thing. I was first going to, lemon meringue pie.
Yeah.
Really, because it gave...
Or an ice cream cone, you know?
Oh.
This is
but
Marcia.
I said chocolate bar. Yeah.
Won't you help?
It's okay.
Can find someone smarter.
Well, I'm sorry.
All right. And let's see what we got.
Motivation, yes.
Here we go.
Give us a good one, pal.
Eunice said,
it's too late.
My blind date treated me like a potato. He tried to blank me.
Come on.
You got it.
Come on.
All right.
Rather old-fashioned term, but it might
idea. All right, ready down here? Okay, Leann? Eunice said, my blind date treated me like a potato. He tried to blank me.
He tried to peel me.
Yeah. How long did you say you've been in this country?
Almost 4 years.
You learn quickly, don't you? All right. Leann, what do you say to that?
Well, I can only contain myself for so long.
Peel it in! Run for air. Chris.
I love Gandhi, too.
Yeah. Hey, love very good. Nancie?
Yippee!
Oh, that's three. She's on a roll. Three up there. Whole upper tier, John.
Peel, 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 and repeal.
Very good. Very good for you.
I'm so embarrassed.
Tried to sack me.
Tried to sack me.
Clever, clever.
Oh, wait a minute.
All right.
You got to think about that one. You know what that hit got. All right.
And also, if she's got a rotten answer, too, then we'll know that they belong together.
David and I are suffering from jet lag, I think, because...
You have.
I said MASH.
MASH.
See how well suited they are for each other. It's going to be a great one.
All right, she's got four. Arla, you've got to do a little catching up here. We'll do that right after this. Over the third and final round, and you're ahead, you have to go first.
A, please.
All right. Only two people play, David and Marcia. Are you ready?
What did I tell you?
The doctor said, some of my patients have water on the knee. Not Rodney Rich. He's so rich, he has blank on the knee.
Rodney's a cousin of mine. I know him well.
Is he?
Could you repeat that, please, Gene?
Yes, of course. Why?
didn't.
You're not even playing. All right, put it in the slot there. Anne, the doctor said some of my patients have water on the knee, but not Rodney Rich. He's so rich he has blank on the knee.
Champagne.
Champagne is good.
That's good.
That's one of the good possibilities. David, what have you got?
Well, we're running pretty close here. Scotch.
Scotch on the knee. Like champagne would be the elegant, proper thing.
Rocks.
Marcia?
Now, I took a different Scotch tack. Rodney Rich is from oil territory, so we got oil.
Oil on the knee. Knee. Perrier. Water on the knee. Perrier. Now
Sorry.
They get it. Well, Sorry. You stay at four, Anne. Now, Arla, this is your last chance. You need four to tie, five to win. Harry said, now, you've heard of the show That's Incredible. Okay, well, there's a new show about my wife's cooking. It's called That's Blank.
Come back
all right,
and do it again.
Arla, here we go. Harry said you've heard of the show That's Incredible. Well,
maybe.
There's a new show about my wife's cooking, and it's called That's Blank.
That's Inedible.
Hey, that's a good one. Hello, cutie. What do you got?
This is for Washington. That's inedible.
That's inedible.
Yay!
So that's one.
It's inedible, folks.
That's two. 4-2 to score. 4-3 to score. She's catching up and she's on a roll. John?
Inedible.
Oh. Tie score, David.
Inedible.
Inedible. Throw down the inedible score. All right, so that means Arla wins the game. Come on down, Arla. Right over here, if you would, please. And we'll get to you in a moment. Anne, it was a pleasure to meet you.
Thank you.
You're very beautiful, and we're going to send some gifts to you from the match game. Anne Roy Chowdhury. Hey there, come on up here. How do you feel? Listen, we're going to switch to Hollywood Squares now. We're going to bring on three more celebrities, and John and I will switch places. And there's the rest of our furniture. We got a lot more excitement coming along. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
A member of our studio audience will receive Gibson side-by-side refrigerator freezer featuring through-the-door ice and chilled water dispensers, automatic ice maker, 24-foot capacity, and exclusive frost-clear system furnished by Gibson. It's time for more of the match game. Hollywood Squares, our with from Days of Our Lives, Deidre Hall. Wayne Northrop. John DeLancie. And taking over the star of the Hollywood Square, John Bauman.
Okay, we'll be right back with Hollywood Squares in a minute. Please join us.
And the Hollywood Square.
Thank you, Gene Wood. So you say your name is Knauer, Arla Knauer, like?
Like Knie or Knife. You can say the K, Knife.
Gotcha. Boy, you wouldn't have believed the telegram she delivered during that commercial break. It was really incredible. I'm so sorry you missed it. We have three brand new stars, all from Days of Our Lives. Wayne Northrop, Deidre Hall, and John DeLancie. Now, they are all up in that upper tier for a reason. They are incredibly interrelated on the program. Am I correct? I'll ask you, Deidre, because are you not in some way or another married to both of these guys on the show?
I am married to both these men.
That's why
I reference. Why don't you just explain that first? How that came to be?
Well, first, I married Roman about a year and a half ago, right, hun?
And a year and a half.
And then he was tragically killed, and then he returned, and then I was pregnant, and when
from the
he
dead?
Was gone.
Ah, there's the rub. Yes.
You're sick.
Get to John quickly.
Anyway, so then when I was in that delicate situation, Eugene decided that he would volunteer that he was the father.
Have you been? That's terrific to have you all here. Have you been following this, Arla?
I'm going to get the book.
Get the book.
Yeah.
Believe it or not, playing Hollywood Squares is going to be much simpler. Here we go.
Our defending champion.
Her name is Linda Forrest. It is her second day. She has so far a total of $1,525. Which means, in a nutshell, that you didn't get the super match, but you could have another crack at it today should you get through Hollywood Squares. Tell us how you spend the days of your lives, Linda, briefly.
Well, I work in the computer industry. I have two children, 16 and 12, and as a hobby, I do a little acting, and as I mentioned last time, I was the hostess at the Mr. Tush Beauty Pageant last year.
Oh, Linda.
You did have to bring that up again.
I don't think that's wise, Chris.
That's okay. We won't hold that against you or anything else that we may have at hand. We will play Hollywood Squares instead until you hear the Time's Up bell. Whoever is ahead at that time is our winner and goes on to play Supermatch. That can be worth up to $30,000. First game is worth $100, $25 for every square. Linda, you get to start because you are the champ. Pick a star and let's go.
Okay, Chris, please.
Chris Rich.
I have the unique record on this show of actually never having gotten a correct answer. So you're forewarned. You remember that? I couldn't believe it. I missed everything.
We can believe it, Chris.
Could change any minute, Chris.
Okay, I'm ready. Okay.
Do glowworms make love with their lights on or off?
Well, I'm sure it's with their lights on. They're quite kinky in terms of being worms.
Agree or disagree, Linda?
I agree.
Glowworms make love with their lights off. Chris continues his incredible string. Left over from months ago. You should have disagreed with him. Your opponent gets the first square.
And he was reading the encyclopedia last night, too. Gosh.
You just never got to G, did
just
it?
Just didn't get to glow.
GL.
Arla Knauer, your move.
I'd like Gene, please.
You would like
sure
Gene.
You would.
He's available.
Thousands of women have said that.
Are you sure?
Mr. Rayburn, Eleanor Roosevelt used to do this to improve her memory. Did she read aloud from the encyclopedia every night, just like Chris? Or did she eat garlic pills every morning?
It's a well-known medical fact that, in some strange way, the brain is like a muscle, and you need to exercise it. This is told to me by a doctor. And one way to exercise it is to memorize. For instance, when I was doing a play once, and he said, that's good for your brain. It gives your brain exercise. So that's the way to exercise your brain.
So read aloud from the encyclopedia every
Absolutely.
Night, I assume. Yes,
yeah.
Garlic pills don't exercise your brain.
No.
Agree or disagree, Arla? She says to improve, Gene says to improve her memory, Eleanor Roosevelt read from the encyclopedia.
I agree.
She ate garlic pills.
Oh, no!
You should have disagreed with Gene and Gene's doctor, and your opponent gets that square. So we got an X and an O up there, and a perfect record of not a right answer yet. Linda Forrest?
Wayne, please.
Okay, let's see.
We're going for three wrong answers.
We'll try to break this spell, Mr. Northrop. Does your average snake grow to a certain length and stop? Or does it... Or does it keep growing until it dies?
This is your average snake.
Your average snake.
We're talking about here, not your abnormal snake. I think it keeps growing. I mean, it sheds its skin all the time. That's why, because the skin gets too small for it, and it's got to get rid of it to grow a new one because it grows.
So he says it keeps growing until it dies. What do you say, Linda?
I agree. Yeah.
It keeps growing until it dies. The spell is broken. You're right to agree, and you get a square. Good for you.
Shedding the skin.
What that means, Arla, is that she's got two X's on the board, and you only got one O. Make your move.
Leann to block.
Oh,
okay.
So afraid.
Come on, Leann.
You missed this one. The game and the lead goes to Linda Forrest. You've just bought your boyfriend some leopard skin bikini briefs.
You wear those, don't you, Leann?
Classy lady.
Now, how did they know
Now, according to Cosmo's Guide to Marvelous Men, is this a good idea, or should you not buy your guys any clothes at all?
Oh, boy. Is it a good idea? Well, I suppose if you want to get kinky or something, but from personal experience...
Yes.
Personal kinky experience.
Gosh, I just got myself in a trap here, didn't I? I would say...
You like
sure, why not?
Sure, it's okay to buy them leopard skin bikini briefs.
Yeah.
Agree or disagree to block, Arla?
I agree.
According to Cosmo's Guide to Marvelous Men, don't buy your marvelous man any clothes at all. You should have disagreed. Your opponent gets that square, and your opponent wins that game. I don't know quite what that means. Cosmo's Guide to Marvelous Men may think your guy shouldn't wear any clothes ever. We will be back to find out what happens in Hollywood Squares, which will be more of a certainty after these messages.
Stay tuned for more of the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. Now back to John Bauman and the Hollywood Squares.
And welcome back, everybody. Next game's worth $200, $25 for every square. Once again, the last game was won by Linda Forrest. So Arla Knauer, start us off.
Chris, please.
Well, that's your first mistake.
The hot seat.
Chris.
Yeah.
You and your wife have slept in the same bed for 15 years.
No.
Have we mentioned yet today that Chris and Nancy are married in real life?
You have not.
John,
unless you mentioned it, we forget it, so it's...
We split up between last time. No big thing.
They are married in real life, not on the show. They're bitterly divorced on the show,
really?
Right?
Absolutely.
Okay, so you and your wife, you can consult each other on this, have slept in the same bed for 15 years. According to the Better Sleep Council, is it time to replace the mattress, or is there still life left in the bed?
Go with it, honey. Our bed. This is our bed.
Our bed's been dead, pal. 15 years, it's a dead bed.
Don't you have a water bed, Chris?
Yes, ours is a water bed, so it's already lumpy. No, that doesn't
work. It evaporated, right?
Yes, right. We burn it right up. I'd say it's a dead bed, get a new one.
Okay, he says replace that mattress. Agree or disagree, Robert?
Watch.
After 15 years.
I agree.
Time to replace the mattress, guys. Yes, you're right to agree, and you get the square. Good for you, Chris. In fact, after 8 to 10 years, you should replace the mattress. You can keep the wife, however. Linda Forrest, pick a star for an X.
Marcia, please.
All right. Okay. Marcia McCabe, into action. Can you trim the brown spots on your fern? Or will scissors give it a fatal shock?
Oh. Me, Miss Non-Green Thumb. No, actually, I do have... We New Yorkers, believe it or not, do have plants, even though the climate is not exactly ideal.
Even though they don't last for more than 3 weeks.
Yes, but...
Yeah. Plastic ones don't.
Actually, yes, you can trim the brown spots off your ferns.
Okay, what do you say, Linda?
Well, I'll agree.
It is okay to trim your fern.
Good.
You're right to agree. You get the square. So now we are on a bit of a roll. Everybody's getting everything right. Arla, try to keep it up for an O.
Nancy, please.
Okay.
You're on, pal.
Nancy Frangione, according to Glamour magazine, what do more women like on a man? Hairy chests? Or the smooth, hairless kind?
I can answer this question very easily. She makes me shave it.
However, I'm not like most people. I think most women, not me, darling, like hair on a man's chest.
Okay.
Sorry, I'm sorry. You know.
She says most women like men with hairy chests.
I'm sure of it. I'm positive.
Agree or disagree, Arla?
I'm going to agree.
Most women like men with hairy chests. You're right to agree. You get the square. Good for you. Okay, Linda Forrest, your move.
Leann to block, please.
Again. Gosh, I did so well.
You missed this one. The game in the lead goes over to Arla.
Pressure's
every time
on
you get to me, it's always interesting.
Sure coincidence. It's raining, Leann. Can you take your fern outside for a bath? Or should you avoid exposing your fern to a rain shower?
A lot of fern time.
You have a fern fixation.
Fernwood tonight.
Oh, but I think, don't a lot of people rain
spritz
on their
fern? Spritz, Leann.
Thank you. Yeah. He needs all the help he can get.
Yes. I'm from rain country. I'm from Washington also. Mm-hmm. So I would say you can take it outside.
Okay. She says, okay, take your fern outside for a bath. What do you say, Linda, to block?
I disagree.
It is okay to take it out for a bath. No, you should have agreed with Leann. Your opponent gets that square and wins that game. Well, the ferns have it that the lead has changed hands. You are ahead with 300 to 200 for you, Linda, Arla. We will be back to find out what happens for the day after these messages. It's close. Okay. We're going to find out what happens in a $300 game.
That's right.
It gets to be started by you, Linda.
Chris, please.
Okay. I got a run going now. I'm ready.
Chris Rich, do most people who get divorced remarry? Or did they learn their lesson the first time?
Boy, once a fool, always a fool. John, they get remarried, pal.
What do you say, Linda?
I agree.
They remarry. You are right to agree, and you get the first square in this game.
Incredible.
They remarry over three quarters of the time, over 75%. Arla, your move.
Wayne, please.
Okay, Mr. Northrop. In the 1975 Super Bowl, the Pittsburgh Steelers were allowed to spend the night before the game with their wives.
Or whoever else they wanted to spend the night. Yes.
But the Minnesota Vikings were not allowed to see their wives. Which team won?
In 75?
Right.
Steelers.
Agree or disagree, Arla?
I will agree.
The Steelers won. Yes, the team who saw their wives won. They may have been the better team, but... Okay, you're right to agree, you get the square. We don't know what that proves, but it proves that we got an even game so far. Linda, your move.
Gene, please.
Gene Rayburn.
Yeah.
You're in Africa at a lion dinner.
Hmm.
Unfortunately, the lion is eating you. Now, is it more likely you're being eaten by a young lion or an old lion?
What does it matter?
It's a point of information.
Good point. Dead is dead. Who cares whether you're eaten by a lion cub or an old lion?
Linda does.
Yes. Now, wait a minute. Let's just logic this out now. It's the female that does the kill and drags the food over. And probably the old lion is the one that feeds last. The young ones probably feed first. So I'd say the young ones.
Okay, so he says a young lion is more likely to be eating you. Agree or disagree, Linda?
I'll agree.
One piece of logic was missed. It is an old lion. You should have disagreed with Gene. Your opponent gets that square. You is the operative word because a lion will eat faster prey like an antelope, generally speaking. It only goes for slower stuff like human beings when it gets old. Otherwise, they're not interested in you at all. Arla, your move.
Oh, trick question.
Yes, you are O, and it is your play.
I'm going to remember that on my next safari.
I'm going to go with Leann, please.
Okay, now this would give you another game and really a pretty big lead in our third segment. Leann, can you tell the sex of your frog by examining his or her fingers, or do you have to turn him or her over?
All that work.
She has a very
unusual
frog.
I'm trying to remember Biology 101. I think you have to turn him over.
What do you say, Arla, for the game?
I disagree.
You could tell the sex of your frog by examining his or her fingers. You did it. You are right to disagree. You get the square, and you win the game. I don't know how you knew that. You could have fooled me. Congratulations, you got 675. How did you know? Oh, I guess if the fingers are manicured, then maybe it's a girl. Anyway, clear the board, move on to the next game. It's worth $400. And Linda Forrest, you get to start. Time is fleeting. Pick a star.
Okay, Chris, please.
Okay.
Mr. Rich.
Yeah.
You're a bean farmer.
You bet.
Which are bigger, your kidneys, your limas, or your garbanzos?
Go, Chris.
Boy, them lima beans are big, and I love them, too. Big and green. Lima beans.
He says the lima beans are the biggest. Agree or disagree, Linda?
I'll agree.
Your limas are the biggest. You're right to agree, and you get the square. Chris Rich, not full of beans, but the bell means that time is up. $675. She has done it. New champ, Arla Knorr. Good for you. Yes. You can go right over there. You can join Gene, get set for your shot at the big money. Good for you. It was that second game. Yeah. You know, she got the three O's and got a little bit too far ahead for you. But she had a lovely day here.
I had a wonderful time. Thank
on
you.
On Friday. And thank you for having a wonderful time in general. Her name is Linda Forrest. Her total is $1,775. Gene, take it away.
Here we go. Here we are with the new champ. We'll be back with her and the nine stars for going to Big Dole right after this.
is Gene Rayburn.
Thank you very much. Here we go. Listen, just before we go, I have to tell you one thing here. You know, none of us over there knew about the frogs, how to tell the sex of a frog. And we thought, well, it was a good guess, but she didn't guess because she looked at one of her kids' frogs, one she just told me, and she turned it over and she said, well, I didn't see anything there, so I figured it had to be by the fingers. That was very logical of her to figure that out.
There
was nothing there.
There
was nothing there
turning that frog over in the first place.
Right.
She had a telegram for it.
You're right. All right, here we go with a big money super match where she could win up to $30,000. You ready?
Oh, I'm ready.
Let's go. We polled an audience not too long ago, and we said, write down your best answer to this. Blank pig. If you give us the answer they chose most often, you get $1,000. The second one, $500. And the third, $250. Any three of the nine stars are allowed to offer a little assistance. Pick them out one at a time.
Chris, please.
I think Porky Pig.
Porky Pig is one.
Mm-hmm. John.
Is there another? Roast Pig.
Okay, two. One more.
Leann, please.
Greased Pig.
Greased Pig. All right. Yeah. They have those in county fairs for contests. Okay. They have Greased Pig, Roast Pig, and Porky Pig. Now, you must choose one of those or think up one of your own.
Porky Pig.
You want Porky Pig? All right, let's see if Porky Pig is up there. We'll go down to the bottom, reveal the $250 response first. Fat Pig.
Fat? That's insulting.
There are none of those around here, I can tell you that right now. The $500 response says, guinea pig.
Sure, that's good. Oh,
that's good. Nice work, stars. So far, you're terrific. All right, here's the last chance for Porky Pig. Go!
As long as we get this one right.
Yeah! Attaboy, Chris. There's your $1,000. You got it. Now, you've got the $1,000. It's time for the head-to-head match with any star of your choosing. And after you've made your decision, that star will take the tab and reveal the hidden number. And going to multiply that $1,000 by whatever number is revealed at that time. It could be a 10, it could be a 20, and somewhere up there is 130, Arla. See if you can pick it.
Chris again, please. Oh!
Chris.
Oh, Chrissy.
Chris. These are those moments that you have nightmares about when they say, you're going on the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour.
$20,000 is what you're playing for. Okay. So far, you've been lucky with Chris, Arla. Let's see if your luck holds out. You better face me because you might be a lip reader for all I know. How do I? Ready, Chris?
Yes.
Here we go. No help from the audience, please, because if we hear an answer, we got to throw it out and start over. Mini blank. That's M-I-N-I blank.
Now that you got it wrong, M-I-N-I. He just missed.
M-I-N-I.
Yeah. Oh.
All right, Chris is ready. Arla, you collect $20,000 by matching him. What do you say to that?
I hope he loves a mini skirt.
Mini skirt?
Mini skirt.
You're not wearing one.
No.
You ever wear one?
Yes.
You do. All right, Chris, she said mini skirt will collect the $20,000. What do you say?
Well, see, I thought it was like M-I-N-N-I-E, and so I thought it was like mini pearl or something like that. Then when it was M-I-N-I, I didn't really know what to put, so I said skirt. I don't know.
And you kissed the soap opera star. You have a total of $21,675. Congratulations. All right, we'll be back with Arla and the stars right after this. Now, Carla did very well. She won the $20,000, but somewhere up there is $130,000. I wonder which star had it. Would you
pull
all
your tabs?
Ready, set, go.
Whoa!
Leann has the big number. Well, you were close. You chose
one
Chris
seat
right
over.
Next to her. Thank you, stars. We'll see you tomorrow. You were splendid. And Arla, we'll look forward to seeing. Are you looking forward to coming back tomorrow?
I'm so excited, yes.
Good. All right. Gene Rayburn inviting you to join us tomorrow.
John Babin saying so long for the Match Game Hollywood Squares, Sarah. See you then.
A member of our studio audience will receive Montgomery Ward's major manufacturer 13-inch portable TV with digital scan across the room remote control. Adjust volume and selects any available channel furnished by Montgomery Ward. This is Gene Woods speaking for the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour, a Mark Goodson television production.